FIA press conference. Joining us today, we have Craig Breen from the Citroën Total Abu Dhabi World Rally Team, Andreas Mikkelsen from the Hyundai Shell Mobis World Rally Team, Elvin Evans from M Sport Ford, and Esa-Pekka Lappi from Toyota. Elvin, we're going to kickstart today with you. We all remember last year and the epic final stage battle. We'll battle throughout the weekend. Luckily, you'll have Dan Barrett back alongside you for this event. Talk to us first about Dan and how he is, and did he test with you prior to the event?
Yeah, Dan's feeling a lot better, thank you. It's obviously good to have him back. Yeah, I mean, he feels pretty much fine in himself now. As far as he was concerned, he was right to go to Corsica, but obviously the medical said otherwise, you know, which you have to respect. But yeah, he's back and feeling fit.
Last year was a great event for yourself. Do you come here bringing that same kind of confidence? Because it hasn't been the best of starts to the season's view.
No, it's been a terrible start, I'll be honest. But yeah, I mean, we're looking at the event as an opportunity. If the rain stays away, then the road position will be good. But at the minute, it's looking very mixed. So let's wait and see. I mean, we have to give it our all and see what happens. We could really do with a good result here.
You talk about the weather conditions, and some of the stages out there are incredibly slippery, especially the Saturday ones. What do you think of the route this year? We see some changes, especially on Sunday with El Condor Mina Clavero reversed. What's your thoughts on the whole route?
Yeah, quite a few changes. I think Friday, some bits are particularly rough, to be honest, compared to how we've seen those stages in the past. So that could throw up a few surprises.
You say bits, any particular stage or just across the loop?
Just sections of the loop, I think. You know, not one stage in particular throughout, but just certain sections seem pretty rough. And then Saturday is now a tricky day. The long stage is very narrow and, you know, very easy to hit something, to be honest. So, you know, it's not going to be an easy one.
What is it going to take to change the season around, do you feel? Can you do anything to change it in terms of the way you're driving? Or has it just been a run of bad luck?
No, I mean, you know, you can't blame it all on bad luck for sure. But I'd say we've been a bit unlucky at points as well. You know, two punctures on the first two rounds and then obviously the accident in Mexico, which then put us on the back foot a bit in Corsica. So, you know, we had a solid result in Corsica given the circumstances, and I think now we just keep building on that.
Okay, Elvin, thank you very much. Let's turn to a man who must be chomping at the bit to get back into action, and that's Craig Breen. We've missed you from two events on the WRC calendar. You return here to Argentina. You must be really ready to go this weekend, right?
It's been a long haul, a couple of weeks and months since I was in the car, so like this, that better?
Yeah.
There we go. So yeah, it's probably the longest I've been out of competition since I was a kid. You know, since I was 8 or 9 years of age, I was lucky enough to be competing, karting or rallying or something every fortnight or so, and then all of a sudden I had 8 weeks twiddling my thumbs, so it's been difficult to watch it, but at the same time, it's so nice to be finally back now.
Did you watch it, is the question. Did you sit at home and watch the coverage?
Well, Mexico had no choice, I was there, but in Corsica I tried my best to turn my back on it, and I couldn't. You know, I was gutted not to be at that one. That's my favourite of the year by a long, long way. So, you know, eventually after a while I literally switched it on, and about 30 seconds later Seb had his accident, so it was not the most conveniently timed to watch it, but yeah, still. A little plug for the WRC All Live. It's absolutely amazing to watch it, and I hope that's my last opportunity to watch it live. But yeah, ready to go back now.
You certainly don't seem rusty, because some great runs this morning at Shakedown. You're obviously feeling happy with the car. I know there's been a change chassis-wise. Can you talk us through that?
Yeah. Okay. We don't want to say it's the Eureka moment just yet until we've put a couple of rally days behind us. But we think that it's something that it's been missing for since the car's creation, really. It's always something that we search for, which is confidence in the rear of the car. With all the drivers that have been at some point along the way have struggled for confidence and to be 100% sure of the rear of the car, and we really think that what we've done now with the rear geometry is we're scared to say solved it, because we've so many times before we've said, "Aye, we've changed this and changed that, and yeah, we've got it now," and then we arrive in a rally and it's not quite what we expected. So for the moment, it's doing all the things that we want, and yeah, we're just really hoping and praying that this is what we've been looking for all along.
With two rallies off, does that give you a fire in your belly to really go out there and push for a good result this weekend? What is the strategy from you?
Yeah, of course, you know, I want to try and carry the momentum that we had in Sweden, you know, and I want to try and continue fighting at the front, and I want to try and make that feel as normal as possible. You know, that's, you know, if I do want to be a world champion, I need to make these fights feel comfortable. So that's the plan, is to try and get as close to the podium as we can. Okay, on Friday we'll have a good row position, hopefully with dry weather, and we'll see where we are Friday evening, and then okay, difficult weather and difficult roads for the rest of the weekend if it's going to be wet. So we'll see. You know, I would dearly love to grab another podium and keep the momentum going.
Okay, Craig, thank you very much. Andreas, let's turn to you now. Looking back at Corsica, we got a sense of real frustration from you. We know how quick you are behind the wheel, but things just weren't going your way there. It wasn't translating into good stage times. What's been the upshot of that? Was it a combination of driver and car?
Well, I since the beginning, driving that car on tarmac, I've been struggling. Told him since the very first time I drove it that this car feels very, very different to what I'm used to, comparing it to both the Polo and the C3. So, yeah, not so many changes been made before Corsica, and I knew that it was going to be a tough rally. I didn't expect it to be that tough, but basically the way to drive is just so different. I felt in Corsica, I've never been driving a rally car before, so I was clueless. I had no chance what to do. But yeah, it feels good now to be back on gravel.
I'm sure it does. It hasn't knocked your confidence,
no? No, I mean, I know how to drive on tarmac. I've done many, many good results. I think I have a podium from every tarmac rally there is. So, yeah, it's just something we have to work on. I think it's pretty clear for the whole team that we were all struggling in Corsica, me more than others, but they are used to the car, so they can adopt their driving. But for sure, changes need to be made if we really want to keep up with the other manufacturers on tarmac. So there are a lot of work being put in before Germany.
There has been a change, obviously, that we see coming into this event, and that's an upgrade to the engine. What can you tell us about that, and what difference is it making?
Makes a lot of noise.
Yeah, it's louder,
it's
right?
It's very, very loud. Yeah, it's got more performance everywhere in the engine range. So it's a noticeable difference to driving. So. I think that should help us a lot here in these past stages here in Argentina.
Talk to me about your thoughts on what you can achieve here in Argentina. Given what you've seen on the recce, the conditions of the stages, what are the hopes this weekend?
I really enjoyed this rally. Always have enjoyed it. I think it suits my driving style quite a lot, with the grip being a little bit sandy. And you can really make an angle of the car early and really attack the corners. And that's the way I like to drive. So. I'm really positive for this weekend. We definitely have to, you know, take a lot of points from the front runners if we want to get back in a championship hope. So, you know, we're here to go flat out and do our best.
Yari Matti told us earlier he thinks El Condor uphill is going to be easier than down. You agree?
Both yes and no. For sure, it's always easier going uphill. But at the same time, downhill, we know the stage so well. Mm-hmm. So we know the tricky parts. But at the same time, it will be new going up, and I think it's possible to make a time difference there, but yeah, it should be a bit safer.
Okay, thank you. Espeka, let's turn to you now. Another event where we haven't seen you in a World Rally car before. You are showing, though, that it doesn't really matter whether you've been in a World Rally car or not. Your pace is exceptionally good on events that you haven't competed in one. What is your hope here? Do you think you'll be able to fight at the frontier?
Sure, no.
How you say that now?
Yeah, but I'm realistic. I mean, you said that I haven't been competing World Rally Cup, but I have never been here, so it's like same kind of feeling what we had in Mexico. We were struggling quite a bit. Okay, half or most of it was my bad driving and these things, but I can clearly see that when you come as a first time. And the others have done many, many times the same stages, and they know the conditions and these things. It's very difficult to match the times.
What has surprised you when you've gone out there, you've done the recce, you've seen the stages this year? Has anything surprised you, the roughness or the nature?
Yeah, especially tomorrow, the stage two, there was quite nasty rocks, which were already visible and quite high. So I got a bit surprised of those. And it will be very soft tomorrow as well, so I don't know what is underneath, and I really don't want to know. So will be a lot of surprises, I guess. Otherwise, it was quite okay. Okay, Sunday is very technical and narrow. And yeah, Saturday you can push a bit more, but as Elfin said, it's easy to go wide and do a small mistake, and if you go a bit wide here, you immediately hit something.
How would you assess what you've done so far this season? Because in Corsica, I think it was the first time we actually saw you happy at a stage end with one of your results. How have you been happier with your start to the season?
Well, let's say I've done mistake in every rally, and if I could take those away, the results could have been much better. So I would really like to have a weekend without a mistake. So it's been very small ones, to be honest. Okay, in Mexico it looked maybe much worse what it actually was. But yeah, these really small things, we need to try to not to make this, and then we can be much more happier on Sunday.
Okay, guys, thank you very much. Are there any questions for any of our drivers? No? Good luck this weekend, everyone. Thank you very much.